writing to drums that feel real and sound real kind of forces the ideas out of you. There's a spark there that it creates. And I, trust me, I've written a lot of songs to horribly programmed drums and to horrible sounding programmed drums. So I know, and it's a battle, you're struggling.
I think anyone out here who writes knows that the better your mixes sound, the more inspirational that can be. And the drums are such an important part, especially what we do.
Using GGD in the writing process for the Periphery demos is really, really crucial because right out of the box, it sounds great. You know, you could just load it up, start getting sounds, you have great quality samples just like at your fingertips.
This album's pretty dark and it's got some slower songs. I have to wonder if that was influenced a little bit just by the drum sound, because there were some sections where the drums were definitely the driving force of that part or song. You know, no one will ever know, but I know that it's just been a very inspirational kit for the writing process. So much so that everyone is kind of basing what our album should sound like off of the Modern and Massive kit, as funny as that sounds.
GGD isn't just used for our metal stuff or our rock stuff. It can also be used in electronic music. And I believe we used a lot of the samples for reinforcing certain electronic drums on our 4 Seconds Ago project, my project with Misha. It's a great way to get really punchy drums to reinforce more synthetic sounding drums. So it really finds a home in both those worlds.
My struggle is trying to connect this rudimentary imaginary idea in my head to real life, to sort of take this dumb riff or simple idea and make it feel human. So having it in the studio, having it writing for these sessions, for the demo process, it was pretty awesome having what we actually would have eventually, drum-wise, just tracking to it, it made our lives so much easier.